Now you will no longer be fishers of fish, but fishers of men. And they followed him from that point on, put out into the deep. Put out into the deep. How many of us can do that? How many of us will take him at his word and do that? What will it mean for you at this time in your life to put out into the deep? It could mean exercising your faith in the midst of an illness. It could mean exercising your faith in a certain job. It could mean exercising your faith in a particular relationship. It could mean doing something that you put off doing for a long time. Even though in your heart you really want to do it. Maybe it's getting back into your former active participation in the church. Or perhaps it's going ahead and surrendering yourself to Christ to accept Him as your Lord and Savior and making yourself available to serve in His church. You may decide to work towards becoming a deacon. You may decide towards becoming an usher, a choir, or even a gospel church minister. The choice is yours today, as He is always willing and happy to welcome you back home. Whenever we step out, whenever we utilize faith as initiative of action, then there is a change in our life. Yeah. We begin to see things differently.
Amen.
Amen. It takes daring to put out into the deep. It takes courage to go into untried waters. It takes courage to move into new directions.
Hallelujah.
It may not always be comfortable and can bring special challenges. It also takes daring to bring forth new ideas that may be ridiculed by others. Ideas that may be original in the whole of humanity, that may be new to the whole human race. It takes faith, but it takes more than just faith. It takes action on our faith. If we want to move to our own new church, it takes more than faith. It calls for our complete determination, our commitment backed by our positive actions.
Yeah.
Before all our prayers can have any significant effect. Someone, and it could be you, will dare to put out into the deep as Peter put his fishing net into the deep and in complete obedience to Christ. Today, or this week, someone, and it can be you, will fail, but will try again and again and again. Do not doubt yourself that I cannot do it. Make the first step, and with faith, God will do the rest. Amen. Simon Peter succeeded in that particular instance we mentioned in catching those fish. But at other times, he failed, didn't he? He succeeded for a little while in walking on the waters. And then he began to sink when he looked around and saw the waves. Until Jesus stretched forth his hand to him. And then, at the close of Jesus' ministry, when terrible things were happening, we find that Peter denied Jesus Christ 3 times in as many hours. But yet, he tried again.
Amen.
He tried again many times, and he persisted.
Amen.
And because he persisted, we find he actually became the embodiment of faith. Amen. In God's people church, we recognize Peter as the disciple that represents faith. You will recall that Jesus asked his disciples, "Who do men say that I am?" They said, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, another say Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." And he said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" And Simon Peter replied, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus said, "Blessed are you, Simon the Jonah. For flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and upon this rock will I build my church.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We have received the good news.
Amen.
Of the gospel. We have to start today to find in our inner strength and meditating daily how and where can I be relevant for the works of Christ? How can I support the church of Christ? How can I also obey and cast my net deep into the universal abundance of God and bring forth fruit? You can do it. I can do it. And God will give the courage to be able to do it.
Amen.
May God bless you all.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Praise the name of